Then Champion and I headed for Jefferson City. But what I didn't know at the time was that a few miles from where I was, there were two other fellows who were also interested in the old man's belongings.
Well, it's about time you got back. Did you get the old man?
Yeah, I got him all right. But not the map.
What? Are you blundering fool? Did you search everything?
Sure I did. I'm telling you, Tony, he didn't have the map with him. There was a wallet, but it just had a lot of junk in it. Pictures, identification, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. There was also some screwy poem about life and riches and a guitar or something. That didn't make no sense.
Are you sure that... Wait a minute. Did you say a poem?
Yeah, but...
What did it say?
I don't remember, Tony. Like I said, it didn't make sense.
Oh, so it didn't make sense. Don't you realize that poem was probably a clue of some kind?
Okay. Don't get sore. The old man had a daughter over in Jefferson City. Like as not, they took all his stuff over the door, including the poem. I'll get it.
You better. And this time, I don't want no slip-up. Get that poem.
Well, I guess that's everything, Miss Powell. That is, and if you can throw some light on how or by whom your dad might have been killed.
I'm sorry, I can't, Mr. Ortiz. As I told the marshal here in Jefferson City, I didn't see Dad very often. However, I'm not surprised this happened.
Why do you say that?
Well, he's much as prophesied as himself in the last letter I got from him almost 2 weeks ago. He wrote me then he was on the verge of striking it rich. He also said that two other men had threatened to kill him unless he cut them in.
Did he say who they were or who the other fellows might be?
No. He only mentioned that if something did happen to him, he'd somehow let me know where the mine was.
Oh, I see. Look, Miss Al, could I take your dad's guitar and this poem we found in his wallet back to town with me? The sheriff and I are following every lead in an attempt to find the man or men who shot your father, and these things might help.
Of course. Take them with you.
Thanks. In the meantime, if there's anything we can do for you, don't hesitate to call on us. Well, Pat, I took the guitar along with the poem we'd found in the old man's wallet and headed back to town. But on the way, I decided to stop and take another look at the spot where Charlie Powell had been killed. In the meantime, though, while I was doing that...
Yes?
Pardon me, lady, but I'm the deputy sheriff from over in Cody County where your father was killed. I was wondering if you could let me take a look at his things.
Oh, why, yes, of course. Come in.
Thank you.
Those are his things over there on that table.
Good. There. Here's his wallet. Now to find that poem he had with him.
Did he say poem?
Yeah. What about it?
Oh, nothing except I let one of the men have it. He's working on a case with me. A Mr. Autry.
Autry?
That's right. You must have just missed him. He left here not over 5 minutes ago.
Did he say where he was going?
No, not that I remember.
Thanks anyway, lady. It must have been a little mix-up somewhere along the line. I'll get him back at the office.
Well, Pat, meanwhile, Champ and I had gone to the spot where the old man had been killed. I got off, did a little looking around, but couldn't find a thing. So since it was getting late, I decided to head back to town and check the sheriff's room again. Anyway, I remember we'd just gone a couple of 100 yards when Kemp made a sudden bullet off the trail.
Who's that, Kemp? What's wrong with you?
Boy, that was a close one. You got behind this rock just in time, boy. They're asking anyhow. Well, let's settle it. There must be something mighty important in either this poem, this guitar, or both. So after taking a good look around and making sure nobody was going to take any more pot shots at me, I decided to get back to Melody Ranch instead of going to the sheriff's office. He'd probably gone home anyway, and beside, I wanted to do a little thinking.
Honest, F.P., Gene. You've been reading that silly poem and playing that guitar for almost 3 hours now. Why don't you give up and go to bed?
I will a little bit, Johnny. Music's gone, but deep inside, a memory from afar. I'll give up, but it's got to be... Hey, I've got an idea. You read it through once, Johnny. Maybe that'll help.
Okay, Gene. Brother, I never thought I'd take up poetry.
Never mind the chatter. Just read what it says.
Life is what you make it, so we're not a mess of pain. If riches be your goal in life, you only got yourself to blame.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Start all over again. And go slow.
Life is what you make it, so we're not a mess of pain. If riches be your goal in life, then you've only you to blame. For the key to being natural like this matter.
Hold it, Johnny, hold it. I think I got it. I didn't think of that before.
What did you think of what before?
The key to being natural. Yes, you know, it is the big natural thing. I'm going to see.
I still don't see what you're trying to prove.
Watch it, Johnny. You just watch.
Well, I'll be. Hey, the whole front of it snapped wide open.
That was the key, Johnny. When I came to be natural, see, Mr. Stone left false open front open.
And he, look there, inside the cover, a lamp burned in the wood.
That sure is, Johnny. And if I'm not mistaken, it's the match of the old man Powell's big straight stuff.
I'll take that guitar.
Hey, what's it?
Don't raise either one of you. Get the guns left.
I sure thing, Tony. Okay. Here they are.
So we're the two who killed old man Powell.
You're half right, cowboy. I planned it. Leslie did it. But you're going to be too dead to tell anybody. Now give me that guitar.
Well, suppose instead you come and get it.
I said hand it to me. And I might add my fingers getting a little sticky on this trigger.
Okay. You win.
I always win, cowboy.
I bet you do.
Well, here it is.
Why, you...
That other one, Johnny.
I got it.
Now, we miss
it. Drop that gun.
Let go of my arm. You're breaking it. I'll drop it.
That's better.
There.
All right, Johnny, now let's get these mavericks into the sheriff. That's the way I got that battered up guitar.
Oh, boy. No wonder you hung it up over the fireplace.
Well, if you ever save my life, I'll hang you up there, too. With a rope around your neck.
Oh. Well, I guess it just proves the old saying.
What old saying?
Music casts charm. I mean, music masks charm. Music has mo- Oh, I mean, oh, forget it.
Songs of all time, I have a little doubt that this next song would rank right at the top. For to think of the West means to think of its music, and to think of its music means to think of this song. So if the boys and girls will join me, here it is. Oh, give me a home where the buffalo. Where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy. Cloudy all day. Here's a melody I dare say is familiar to most of you. It bears the simple title, Yours. And we sincerely hope it is. Yours till the stars have no glory. Yours till the birds fail to sing. Yours till the end of life's story. This pledge to
Cowdy Boys, the Pinafores, Carl Trotner, and America's favorite cowboy, Gene Autry. Charlie Lyon speaking. This is the United States Armed Forces Radio Service, the voice of information and education.